This is the Oso Orange Pixel 4 XL. Now, there's a lot of things to talk about with the Pixel 4, and I got to use it for a few days. Google, they sent this over to me as a gift. This is not a sponsorship video. They sent the phone over for me to review, to take some photos and to share my thoughts on it. And that is what I'm gonna do in this video. So one of the big features about this phone is that it has face unlock. And I'm very curious about that. In fact, I'm gonna set it up right now. When I first turned on the phone, I didn't have it set up. So now I'm gonna go into settings and I'm gonna search for face unlock. And it pops up right there. Face unlock. Here we go. It says how to set up face unlock. And it is telling me to rotate my head. Okay, let's do this. Okay, so now let's see if it works. So as you can see right now, my phone is locked. I'm not touching anything. And it unlocked. That's pretty cool. Okay, so face unlock works. One thing to know about face unlock is that if you have siblings that look like you, that are almost identical to you, they might be able to open your phone with face unlock. So that is something to consider. I don't really have siblings that look like me that much, so I think I'm good. I might test that out though. Anyway, let's move on to Motion Sense. Motion Sense is one of the new features in Pixel 4, and some people might consider it a gimmick, but I think it's kind of cool. Basically, Motion Sense allows you to control certain features like music playback and your alarm, or declining a phone call, by waving your hand in front of it. And for me, it actually works. I know some people, they kind of have some issues with it, but for me, it works. You just gotta do a clear motion. You just can't really like wave your hands in front of it and hope that it works. I think I'm gonna use it the most when it comes to hitting the snooze button, because I have my phone right next to my pillow, and it's easy for me to just wave my hand around. Just to hit that snooze button. It's probably gonna be a bad thing, but that's what I'm gonna use it for. So unlike the Pixel 3, there is no front-facing wide-angle lens, and my phone just unlocked. That's the face unlock. I'm getting used to that. Yeah, there's no front-facing wide-angle lens. They took that out to make room for the Motion Sense, which that could be debatable if it's gonna pay off or not. No wide-angle lens on the back. I don't know exactly why they did that, but they did it. If you look back at my Pixel 3 review, the wide-angle lens was pretty much my favorite feature of the phone. I didn't really use it for group shots just because I don't take group selfies, but for vlogging, it was great. I was able to hold my phone not too far away from me. I was able to hold it at close range and get the entire background. But it's gone now, and the Pixel 4 is my main phone now, so I'm dealing with it. I have some photos posted on my Instagram. I think that's the best way to actually show the camera. You know, I can talk about it for an hour, and people do this. I listen to podcasts where they talk about the camera for literally an hour. They'll compare it to other phones, the iPhone. They'll spend a long time talking about it. And at the end, it doesn't really help. So I feel like that's a little bit of a waste for my time and your time. So my thing is just look at the photos. But I am going to talk about the telephoto lens, which is brand new on the Pixel 4. So for example, I was in Dumbo and I zoomed in. And when I zoomed in, it was really blurry on my screen. I'm like, wow, the zoom is terrible. It's not gonna look good at all. And then when I looked back on it, the finished photo looked pretty good. I mean, it didn't have all the details that you expect, but it looked pretty good for a photo that is zoomed in to the max. It's an 8x zoom. So this photo is pretty cool because you can see pretty much all of Dumbo Park. And then I zoomed in, you can see the carousel. So also while I was there, I saw some guys jet skiing and I decided to zoom in on them. And you can see that photo right here. That came out pretty cool as well. Last thing, portrait mode. I actually like it. I like these photos. Look at that. I think they came out pretty great. So I'm already seeing a bunch of comparison photos with the iPhone and the Pixel 4. I think the Pixel 4 is already out right now. Let me know what you guys think about the photos. And if you guys have any questions about the Pixel 4, let me know in the comments below. Or you can let me know on Twitter, @TechGeekNelson.